Welcome back. In this video, we're going to talk about place value. First of all, place value is just a fancy way of saying that we put numbers next to each other. In other words, every time we add a digit, it makes a bigger number. You already know that our smallest numbers have only one digit. Then, when we reach 10, we have two digits, hundreds have three digits, and thousands have four digits. Each place has a name, and their names are actually very simple. The place values are the ones, tens, hundreds, and thousands. We can keep adding places forever, but for now, let's stick with just these four place values. With place values, we can make any number. We'll be building on the idea of place values, so make sure you're comfortable with it. We'll use it for our more advanced ways of counting, like addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division. If you can memorize the names of each place value, that's really all you need to know at this point. Remember that the smallest place value is on the right, and they get bigger as we move left. In other words, using more place values will make bigger numbers. Well, why do we even need place values? Well, you'll remember that we don't have a ton of digits, right? We really only have 10 digits to use, 0 through 9. As we count from 0, eventually we run out of digits to use. 7, 8, 9, is 9 the highest we are allowed to count? Of course not. You know that we can count much higher than that. That's where place values come in. I'll give a quick example for you to visualize place values. So, for this example, I'm not going to call them place values. Let's call them place buckets. In the ones place, we'll put a bucket. In the tens place, we'll put another bucket. And we'll put buckets for the hundreds and thousands places as well. Now you can see that each bucket will hold whatever we want to count. I've had a bit of a pet problem. I have stacks and stacks of kittens piling up around my house. So let's use them for our example. To count, we start with the ones place, like always. At first, we don't have any kittens in our ones bucket, so there is obviously zero kittens in there right now. And as we start to count the kittens we put in our bucket, eventually we run out of digits just like before. Uh-oh! But when we add kitten number 10, our bucket's overflowing. So let's take our ones bucket that has 10 kittens, and we can put it in our tens bucket. The tens bucket is used to count how many times we have filled up the ones bucket. So when we put our 10 kittens in the tens bucket, you can see that we have one group of 10 kittens in that bucket now. Now we can start over with a new ones bucket until it overflows with 10 kittens too. Now we have two groups of kittens in the tens bucket. When we've counted 10 more kittens, we can put that group in the tens bucket too. That's why it's called the tens place value, because it keeps track of how many groups of 10 we have. We can keep filling up the ones bucket and moving our groups of kittens over to the tens bucket until, now our tens bucket is full. Can you guess what we do now? Yep, we have 10 groups with 10 kittens each, which means we have a big group of 100 kittens in our tens bucket. So now we'll put our group of 100 kittens into the hundreds bucket. Just like the tens bucket counted how many groups of 10 we had, the hundreds bucket counts how many groups of hundreds we have. And this pattern of filling up the ones bucket, filling up the tens bucket, filling up the hundreds bucket, and eventually filling up the thousands bucket can continue on forever. See, math uses a lot of patterns just like this one. Fill the bucket, use the next bucket. Fill the bucket, use the next bucket. Fill the bucket, use the next bucket. Well, you get the picture. Just know that most math books and math programs don't have buckets and cute kittens lying around like I do. So instead, they'll use boxes or lines for their place values. And a lot of times, they'll just use groups of blocks to count instead of groups of cute kittens. Personally, I think kittens are more fun, but whatever. It still works the same. We still count up until we're out of digits. Then we put that group in the next place value and start counting over again, just like with buckets of kittens. And that's how bigger and bigger numbers are made. I told you, math is just counting. Now you can use place values or place buckets to keep track of your numbers as you learn faster ways to count. Well,